Marianne Zotos again, Charleston, Rhode Island. Talking about the water draw and the contamination of the site, I understand from the Charlestown Citizens Alliance that this question has already been brought up and that the EFSB believes that the draw sites are far enough away that it won't be an issue, but I would like to know and would like to see some sort of actual study done to prove that, or has that been done? It looks to be as if the last time that study was done was in 1981 and it took 3.5 years, so it doesn't really seem like that might have actually happened again under the current circumstances, the conditions that may have changed since then, and when that study was last done, they weren't looking to draw this quantity of water that they're talking about. So are we using current data anyway? The other thing that has struck me as I've listened to people talk and bring up the Rhode Island Forest Resources Management Plan, the Land Use 2025, the water plans for 2030, and then we look at every single city and town and municipality has planning commissions. These all cost money. Someone is spending time and effort, and we are all paying for that, not just in Charlestown, not just in Burrillville, but on the local level, statewide, and then at the state level. So what the heck have all those people been doing for all those years and all these years and the years they've been doing it and looking forward if none of it really matters because this is going to blow up all of those plans? So are they going to get their money back? Are we all going to get our money back and new money to come up with some new plans that can work around this? Or are we just going to say, hey, sorry, Charlie, you just dumped your money down the toilet and, oh, by the way, you might not be able to flush your toilet anymore. You know, this doesn't really seem like it's taking into account a lot of considerations. And I'm just wondering, I'm hearing about all these things for the first time. I'm just a woman who gets up and goes, does my job and, you know, all the things that we do every day. But I'm not trying to give a permit to a $1 billion fracking plant. So I may not know about all these things, but I feel like you guys should know about these things. And I'm wondering, it seems like, given the point of most of those plans being in direct contradiction with the outcome of this end result if the permit goes through, it doesn't really seem like you necessarily have all that information. And so I'm wondering, what information do you have related to all of those plans? I'm rambling now, it's a little unthought out, I admit. But I think the point is there. There's a lot of effort being expended around the state to plan, and it seems like this board should have known and be looking at all of those things and maybe not finding out about it from the rest of us tonight and all the other nights. Thank you.
Thank you.